Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. And today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to crochet a sweater. You're going to need your yarn. I'm using this gray. You'll need stitch markers, a 4.5 millimeter hook, and a pair of scissors. So let's get started. So you're going to begin by making a slip knot. And then you're going to make a chain of 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80. All right, so you're going to make sure your chain is not twisted. You're going to slip stitch to the first chain. You're going to slip stitch to the first chain to make a loop. And chain one, this does not count as a stitch. Into the same stitch, you're going to go in with one single crochet. And then one single crochet into the next stitch. One single crochet into the next stitch. And you're going to place one single crochet into each of the stitches all around. You should have a total of 80 single crochets at the end of the row. And when you arrive at the end of the row, you should have 80 stitches. You'll slip stitch on top of the first single crochet you made. And now what we are going to do is you're going to divide. I've already divided mine. You're going to divide your work into four parts, and you find your stitch markers from where you slip stitched in. That is one stitch, so you'll mark the 13th stitch. Put a stitch marker in the 13th stitch. And then you'll put a stitch marker into the 28th stitch, and you'll put a stitch marker into the 53rd stitch, and then into the 68th stitch. Okay, you mark the 13th stitch, the 28th and 53rd, and then your 68th. So if you're done marking them, we're going to move on to the second row. You're going to turn your work, chain one. This does not count as a stitch. Into the same, not count as a stitch. Place one single crochet into the same stitch, and then place a double crochet in the next stitch. Single crochet in the next stitch. Double crochet in the next. You're going to alternate between a single crochet and double crochets. All right, single and a double crochet. Single crochet in the next stitch. Double crochet in the next stitch. single crochet in the next stitch and double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet and double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet in the next stitch and double crochet into that stitch marker. For now, first take it out. You're going to double crochet into that stitch marker, single crochet into the same stitch. This is going to be a corner. Mark that middle stitch, which is a single, and then double crochet in the same stitch. So in this one stitch, you've placed a double, single, and a double. We are going to be following the pattern. And then since you ended with a double, you're going to single crochet in the next stitch, double crochet in the next, single, and a double, single crochet, double crochet. And you're going to alternate between the single crochet and the double crochet until you reach where the stitch marker is. And I'll show you what to do next. So when you arrive the stitch marker, since you've ended with a double crochet, into where the stitch marker is, you go in with a single crochet and a double crochet in the same stitch. Mark that stitch because it's going to be the middle stitch, and then a single crochet in the same stitch. Then continue with the pattern, double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet, double crochet, single crochet. And continue alternating between these two stitches until you reach the next stitch marker. So I've arrived at the next stitch marker. I ended with a single crochet, which means in the stitch marker you are going to place a double crochet, single crochet in the same stitch. Mark that stitch and finish it off with a double crochet. And then you continue with the pattern, single crochet in the next stitch, and then you'll place a double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet in the next stitch, and double crochet into the next stitch. Do that until you arrive at the next stitch marker. And a double crochet. So when you finish with the double, into the stitch marker you're going to place a single crochet, a double crochet in the same stitch, mark it, and then a single crochet, double crochet into the next stitch, single crochet in the next stitch, double crochet and a single crochet. Do that until you arrive at the end of the row. And a double, single, double, single, and a double. You should end with a double since you started with a single crochet. So you're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet that you made to finish off this row. So now if you noticed, we placed three stitches in one stitch, and this part is going to fall on your shoulders, and this is going to be the chest area. Let's move on to the next row. So for the next row, you're going to turn your work and chain one. This does not count as a stitch. Since you slip stitched into a single crochet, you're going to place a double crochet into that same stitch. And on top of the double crochet, you're going to go in with a single crochet. Into the single crochet, you're going to go in with a double crochet and a single crochet on top of the double crochet. So our pattern is going to this is how our pattern is going to be. Each double crochet in the previous row gets a single crochet, and each single crochet in the previous row gets a double crochet in the next row. So you're going to alternate between single and a double crochet. So into that single stitch, you're going to go in with a double crochet and a single crochet on top of the double crochet. Double crochet in the single crochet and single crochet into the double crochet. Double crochet into the single crochet. Single crochet on top of the double crochet. Double crochet in the single crochet. Single crochet in the double. Double crochet in the single. And when you arrive at the stitch marker, since it is a double crochet, you're going to go in with a single crochet in that stitch and a double crochet into the same stitch. You mark that stitch since it is our corner, and then a single crochet in the same stitch. Then you continue with the pattern. Since this is a single crochet, you'll go in with a double crochet, single crochet in the next, which is a double, and double crochet in the single. Do that until you arrive the next stitch marker. You arrive the stitch marker. So it is, since it is a single crochet, you're going to go in with a double crochet and a single crochet in the same stitch. You mark that stitch. Then double crochet in the same stitch. Then you're going to continue with the pattern. Since this is a double, it will get a single crochet, and the single will get a double crochet. Single crochet in the double, and double crochet in the single. Do that until you arrive at the next stitch marker, and you'll still follow the pattern three stitches in the same stitch following the pattern, alternating between a single and a double. So I'll show you what I mean. Go ahead and finish your stitches and we meet at the stitch marker. Alright, the stitch marker, since it is a double, you'll place a single crochet, a double crochet in the same stitch, mark that stitch, mark the double crochet, and then a single in the same stitch. Then you're going to continue placing your stitches. In the single, you place a double crochet. In the double, you place a single. Double crochet in the single. And single crochet into the double. Double crochet in the single. And single crochet into the double. And when you arrive at the next stitch marker, you're going to do the same thing, follow the pattern. This is how easy this sweater is going to be. And I'm sure you're going to love the outcome. When you arrive at the end of your row, you should end it with a single crochet since we started with a double. Then you'll slip stitch on top of the first stitch on top of that double crochet to finish off this row. Now, this is how your work should look like. It will be expanding as you keep working in rows, and I'm going to be letting you know how many rows I'm going to work. You're going to repeat this pattern. I just follow, remembering that each single crochet gets a double crochet and each double crochet gets a single crochet. At end of each row, you turn your work to begin the new row. Whenever you start with a single crochet, you should end with a double crochet. And when you start the row with a double crochet, you should end with a single crochet. So I'm going to let you work your rows. Don't forget to increase at the corners, just like I've been showing you. And I'll get back, I'll let you know how many rows I've made. Okay, so guys, I'm back with 20 rows. I made 20 rows of the pattern. And that's going to be enough for me. So the next row, we are going to be splitting the arms, the armholes actually. We are going to turn our work. And you will chain one, which still does not count as a stitch. Since you slip stitched in a double, this is going to be a single in the same stitch. And then a double in the next stitch. By now I'm sure you know how this pattern goes. So go ahead and continue with the pattern, alternating between the single and double crochets until you reach the first stitch marker, and then I'm going to show you what to do. So I arrived at the stitch marker, and you can take that out. Since this is a single crochet, you'll go in with just one double crochet. Then you're going to chain 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You're going to skip all the rest of the stitches and you'll find the next corner. Take out the stitch marker and you'll single crochet, since it is a double, you'll single crochet into that corner, and then you'll continue with the pattern. And this time around, we are not increasing. We are just going to be placing one stitch in the corner. So continue with your pattern. Since this is a single, the next will be a double crochet. Single, double crochet, single crochet, double crochet, and continue doing that all the way to the next corner. And when you reach the corner, I'll show you what to do. Okay, so when you arrive at the next corner, you're going to take out your stitch marker. Since it is a single crochet, you'll go in with one double crochet, chain 8, then skip the rest of the stitches and find the next corner. Since it is a double crochet, you'll go in with a single crochet. Then you'll double crochet into the next stitch, because we're not increasing in the middle stitch. Double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet in the next, double crochet, and continue with the pattern. You're going to continue with the pattern to the end of the row. So when you arrive at the end of the row, you will slip stitch to end the row. At the end of the row, I'll slip stitch to the first stitch I started with. I'm going to show you how your work should be looking like at this moment. This is how your work should look like. These chains are going to be under our arms. You're going to turn your work for the next row. Chain one. Since this is a single, you go in with a double crochet. Single crochet in the next, double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet, double crochet. Do that until you arrive the chain space. So when you arrive at your first corner, since it was a single crochet, you're going to go in with a double crochet. And you're going to single crochet into the next chain. Double crochet into the next. Single crochet in the next chain. And double crochet into the next. single crochet, double crochet, single crochet, since this was a double, to get a single crochet, then double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet, and follow along with the pattern, double crochet, single, and double crochet. So in the into the chains you work to the grid stitch as well. So you're going to continue with the pattern until you arrive the next corner. This time we are not increasing anything, so you're just going to alternate between your singles and doubles. The next corner, since it is a single, I will double crochet, single crochet in the next chain, double crochet, single crochet, double crochet, single crochet, double crochet, single crochet, and you're going to single crochet. Since it was a double, you will single crochet, and then you continue with the crochet stitch, double crochet in the next stitch, single crochet, and double crochet, and this is how your work will look like. Make sure the stitches you have on the chain are the same as on the other side. Okay, so continue doing that until you arrive at the end of the row. At the end of the row, you'll slip stitch to the first stitch. And you turn your work. This next row is just going to, you're going to make rows until you're satisfied with the length of the sweater that you want to have, because we are not going to increase anything, we're just going to work in rounds. So you chain one, does not count as a stitch, single crochet into that same double crochet, and then double crochet into the single crochet, single crochet, double crochet, single, the double, single, and a double. You're going to work all the way around to the end of the row. you slip stitch and turn your work, and you continue working in rounds until you get the length of the sweater that you want. So I'm going to let you do that, and when we are back, I'm going to show you how to do the finishing at the bottom of the sweater. I'm back and I've made 44 more rows to get the length of the sweater that I needed. You can actually make it longer or shorter, it's all up to you. I prefer mine to be this long. It's perfect for me. And now we are going to work on the ribbing. But before we work on the ribbing, we are going to place single crochets all around like we did from the start. You're going to turn your work. Chain one, which does not count as a single crochet. Single crochet into the same stitch. And then you're going to single crochet into each of these stitches. You just go in with one single crochet in each and every stitch until you arrive the first single crochet you started with. Make sure to place one single crochet into each and every stitch, be it a double. So I've arrived at the end of my row with single crochets. I'll slip stitch on top of the first single crochet. I'll slip stitch on top of the first single crochet. And I'm going to turn my work. So for this row, you're going to chain 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Add one more, which will not count as a stitch, to make 11. Single crochet into the second chain from hook, and into the rest of the chains. Go in with single crochets. You should have 10 single crochets in total. So I have 10 single crochets. I'll skip one stitch and then I'll slip stitch into the next stitch. Turn your work. Chain one, this does not count as a stitch. Into the next stitch, but in the back loops only, you're going to go in with single crochet, and then single crochet in the back loops only into the rest of the stitches until you arrive at the end of this row. You should still have 10. You should have 10 single crochets in the back loops. So into the last stitch, you will single crochet into both loops. turn your work, chain one, does not count as a stitch, single crochet in the back loop in the same stitch, and single crochet into each of the stitches. You should keep count of your stitches. You should have 10 stitches, 10 single crochets on the ribbing. And into the last stitch, make your last single crochet, skip one stitch and slip stitch into the next stitch. You're going to turn your work and chain one. It does not count as a stitch. In the back loop into the next stitch, you're going to single crochet and also into the next stitches. Into the last stitch, you go into both loops. And this is what you're going to repeat all the way around until you arrive the first line of single crochets. So into the last stitch, you go in to the both loops and single crochet. You turn your work and chain one. You'll go all the way down into the back loops only with single crochets. You skip one stitch and slip stitch in the next. You chain one and keep repeating this until you arrive the first single line of single crochets. And this is the effect of the single crochets in the back loops. Gives you a nice ribbing. Now go ahead and do that. We will meet up at the end of the row. Okay, so I finished my single crochets and this is how the bottom of my sweater looks like. It has this nice ribbing. So at the end of the row, you will slip stitch to the last stitch. And then you pull that yarn through like this. Pull the yarn, cut the yarn somewhere and pull, leave a long tail. So what you're going to do is you're going to sew up this both ends together like this. You can use a yarn needle or just your hook. So I'm going to sew up the ends together to complete this row. So at the end of both edges, chain one, pull your yarn through, and then make sure to fasten your work so that it does not untie itself. And there, your bottom is done. So let me quickly show you what you're going to do at the arm. Because I already made one arm, I'm going to show you how you're going to make yours. So for the arm, you're going to make a slip knot. Then you're going to find the middle stitch under the armhole where the chains are. You'll find the middle stitch and insert your hook there. Slip stitch, chain one. This does not count as a stitch. So under the armhole I have about 8 stitches. So what I'm going to do is I'll single crochet into that first stitch where I slip stitched in. We'll single crochet 2 together. So I've pulled and I've not pulled through both. I'll insert my hook into the next stitch and then I'll pull through all the three loops. Insert your hook in the next stitch and into the next to single crochet 2 together. So we are going to count these as 2 stitches. Okay, single crochet into this next stitch at the corner. And then since this is a double crochet, we are going to keep track of the stitches. You're going to single crochet into that double crochet and then double crochet into the single crochet. And double crochet. So follow the pattern until you arrive this other corner, and then I will show you what to do before we slip stitch to the first single crochet. So I've arrived my corner and I've ended at the corner. I made a single crochet. So we are going to single crochet 2 together, just like we did on this side. So you're going to insert your hook, pull through, you have 2 loops on the hook, insert your hook in the next, pull through, and pull through all 3 loops, insert your hook in the next stitch and into the next stitch and pull through all 3 loops. So now you're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet 2 together. You're going to turn your work. Why we are single crocheting 2 together is to close up that not leave any space. So you're going to chain 1. This does not count as a stitch. So since here you ended with a single crochet at the corner, you're going to begin by a double crochet. Double crochet into that same stitch. Single crochet in the next stitch, double crochet in the next stitch, and into the double crochet you're going to single crochet and then double crochet into the next single crochet into that double, and you're going to keep the pattern going until you arrive the first stitch, the first double crochet, and then you'll slip stitch. So go ahead and work your pattern and then we meet at the end of the row. Make sure if you started with a double crochet, you should end the row with a single crochet. That's very important. That's when you'll know that your stitches are on track. When you arrive at the single crochets that we made, you just have to continue with the pattern. So since this is a double, into the single you'll make a single crochet and then a double crochet in the next single and then a single crochet in the next single. To end the row, you slip stitch to the first stitch. You're going to turn your work and chain one. Since this is a double, it's going to get a single crochet, just like I've been doing for the body of the sweater, and then a double crochet into the single, single in the double and double in the single. And you're going to repeat this for a total of 44 rows. At the end of each row, you turn your work and chain one, which does not count as a stitch, and then you continue working the pattern, alternating between the singles and the doubles. So once you have 44 rows on your sleeve, this is how it should look like. And for the next row, you're going to turn your work and chain one. This does not count as a stitch. Into the same stitch, you're going to go in with a single crochet, and then you'll single crochet into the rest of the stitches. Place one single crochet into each and every stitch until you reach the first single crochet. So go ahead and do that, and we meet at the end of the row. At the end of the row, slip stitch to the first single crochet and turn your work. Chain 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Single crochet into the second chain from hook and single crochet into the rest of the stitches. In total, you should have 11 single crochets. In total, you should have 10 single crochets, sorry, because the 11th chain does not count as our stitch. So you should have 10 stitches, 10 single crochets. Skip the next stitch and single crochet into the next one. Turn your work, chain one. We are going to single crochet into the back loops only. So single crochet into the first single crochet, but in the back loops, and single crochet into the next. Single crochet in the next stitch, and keep single crocheting until you arrive the last stitch. In the last stitch, you will single crochet into both loops. Single. Yeah. And then in the last stitch, you go in with both loops. You should have a total of 10 single crochets. You're going to turn your work chain one. In the first stitch, single crochet into the back loop. And single crochet in the back loops in the next 9 stitches. We're just doing the same thing we did at the base of the sweater. Skip one stitch, slip stitch into the next, and turn your work. Chain one, and you're going to single crochet all the way up, and in the last stitch you single crochet into both loops. You're going to repeat this all around, and when you arrive the last stitch, you'll sew up both ends together to complete the row. Okay, so I finished making the single crochets and I made sure to stitch both ends together, and I did the same for the neck. I made a ribbon for it. All you do is you attach your yarn anywhere in any of the stitches, and you make single crochets all across. Then you turn your work. You do exactly what you did on the arm, and that's all you do. Your sweater is done. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notification to get updates on new videos. See you again in the next video. Don't forget to screen all your ends.